A year ago, Kim Tebby started getting severe headaches and problems with her eyesight, all affecting her work as a graphic designer. After a barrage of testing, she was shocked to learn she had multiple aneurysms in her brain.
I said, am I going to die? Because again, I was like so upset, I didn't know. And he said, if one bursts, you will.
Aneurysms are a ballooning in a weakened blood vessel and can trigger a life-threatening bleed if they rupture. After initial testing at her community hospital, Kim was referred to Sunnybrook neurosurgeon Dr. Leo Da Costa, whose surgical team offers several approaches to fix the problem. Kim was a candidate for a less invasive approach called endovascular treatment.
You don't have to open the head, you make a puncture in the groin and you push the catheters up under continuous guidance of the x-ray. And you are able to place catheters inside the aneurysm or inside the vessel that feeds the aneurysm and close it in many ways with coils or stents.
Here you can see the metal catheter coiling up inside an aneurysm. This will disrupt blood flow and shut down the aneurysm.
Because we want at the end, in a picture like this, we want to have no flow inside here, or minimal flow inside here, normal flow in the blood vessel.
Because it's less invasive, this endovascular approach offers patients many benefits, including reaching previously untreatable aneurysms, a reduced risk of complications, and a shorter recovery. Most patients go home the very next day, like Kim.
I'm so thankful of technology today and to be at the age I am so that I can take advantage of all this.
Dr. Da Costa says not everyone is a candidate. It depends on the size, location, and shape of the aneurysm. But for those who are eligible, endovascular treatment offers a much easier option. With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis. Dr. Da Costa doesn't like this guy.